So now we are going to lesson 5 at page 46 of your textbook. Please open at page 46. Lesson 5, Land of Pharaohs. Here we get a new word, Pharaohs. Pharaohs is a term which is applied to indicate the king or the ruler of ancient Egypt. At first, we shall read the introductory paragraph. Today, we shall get an explanation of the introductory paragraph line by line. Please follow me. The civilization we call ancient Egypt flourished about 5,000 years ago when the rule of the pharaohs began. The civilization, refinement or social process of development we call ancient Egypt. Ancient means primitive, and Egypt is a country of Africa. Flourished means developed about 5,000 years ago. That is, the Egyptian civilization existed nearly 5,000 years ago, when the rule of the pharaohs began, and during the rule of the pharaohs, it flourished, it developed. Or in other language, the pharaohs ruled in Egypt nearly 5,000 years ago when the Egyptian civilization developed there. They made Egypt a rich and powerful nation, admired throughout the ancient world. They means the pharaohs or the kings or the rulers of Egypt. They made, that is, the pharaohs made Egypt a rich and powerful nation. They were boastful to be a rich and powerful, strong nation in the world, admired throughout the ancient world. That is, the Egyptian civilization was praised throughout the ancient or primitive world. Okay. Now we are again to our lesson. They also ordered the building of great temples and elaborate tombs for themselves. This was another side of the rule of the pharaohs. They ordered for the setting up of great temples. Temples means shrines, S-H-R-I-N-E-S. And elaborate tombs and huge tombs, graves, for themselves. The Egyptians believed that all pharaohs were god kings. It was the strong belief within the people of the Egypt, who are called Egyptians, that the pharaohs were sent by the god. That's why they were termed as god kings. It was their belief that the kings were there, the pharaohs were there to rule over them. And believed means here trusted. Ancient Egyptians used picture writing called hieroglyphics for inscription in the tombs and temples. I have already told you that the Egyptian kings or pharaohs made arrangement for setting up or establishment of tombs and temples, and certainly there were some writings or inscription on the tombs and temples, and they used, the primitive Egyptians used picture writing, which was known as hieroglyphics. Ancient Egyptians used picture writing called hieroglyphics for inscription in the tombs and temples. I think it is clear to you. Right, next. Paper was made from thinly sliced papyrus stems. They also invented a way to make paper, to prepare paper. They used as the raw materials papyrus stems, or they thinly cut, sliced papyrus stems in order to prepare paper. The following tale in the pictures describes Israel's wonder as he visits Egypt for the first time. There is a tale which is described in picture. It is the description of the surprise of a child who visits Egypt for the first time. So now we are going to Egypt, and consider yourself to be the main character here, that is Ishan. So let us start our journey to Egypt. Cairo, Egypt. Cairo is the capital of Egypt. Here the destination of Ishan is Cairo, Egypt. So finally we are in Cairo. So finally we have reached our destination, that is we have reached Cairo ultimately. We are going to Giza, Ishan, to see the three great pyramids. Then till the time we don't know who is he or she who is speaking with Ishan, but afterwards it will be clear to you. At this very moment I am not telling you who the character is or the identity of the character. I am doing so in order to continue your curiosity. We are going to Giza, Ishan. Someone is telling Ishan that they are going to Giza to see the three great pyramids. Here we have a new word, pyramids. The tombs of the pharaohs were called pyramids. And from this very line, it is clear that in Giza, there are three great pyramids, or three great pyramids are situated in Giza. I have already told you that consider yourself, imagine yourself to be Ishan. And I think that the same question is rising in your mind. And it is, or the question is, what's a pyramid, Maha? Here Ishan wants to know the description or the meaning of the word pyramid. And I think the identity of the character is now clear to you. If you are in the classroom, I shall ask you the identity, but now in this virtual class it is not possible. So I am telling you the identity. The character is Ishan's mother. Here Ishan's mother is answering to Ishan's question by saying that a pyramid is a huge triangular monument, the burial ground of the pharaohs. It is the fine definition of a pyramid, and it will be very convenient for you, I think, if you can memorize this very definition. A pyramid is a huge means elaborate, very large, or enormous, triangular, having the shape of a triangle. Or we can explain it in other language that triangular is the adjective form of triangle. A monument. Monument is a building which is erected, which is built in order to remember a person. The burial ground of the pharaohs, pyramid is the grave of the pharaohs. And who are pharaohs? The Egyptian rulers were the pharaohs. Now, Ishan throws another question, and who is a pharaoh? I think you have already got the answer, and in this regard, you are a step further than Ishan. Here the answer is that a pharaoh is an Egyptian king. The pharaohs lived around 5000 years ago, which I have already explained to you in the introductory paragraph. We have learned that the Egyptian civilization flourished or developed nearly 5000 years ago, and the rulers who ruled during that period or in that civilization were called pharaohs. They were Egyptian kings of that or during that civilization. We are going to see so many interesting things. I wish Father had come with us. It is the realization of Ishan that he hopes that they were going to see a lot of interesting things. It is his wish that it would be far better if his father could join with them. Now we shall notice how Ishan's mother respond to this suggestion. The prize I won at the singing competition entitled only to for a sponsored tour of Egypt. Your father wanted you and me to come. Here the reality is that Ishan's mother won a singing competition, and as a reward of that winning, she got an entitlement to travel to Egypt, and it was entitled for only two persons. Ishan's father wished that Ishan should accompany his mother. That's why they too are only in this tour to Egypt. Now the team, that is Ishan and his mother, are in front of a pyramid. What's that, Ma? Here Ishan asks his mother about the thing which was in front of them. Here Ishan's mother response is that that's the Sphinx, Ishan. It's a rock statue with a human head and a lion's body. In front of them there was a statue, and it was made of rock. It is called the Sphinx. It has a peculiar structure. Its head is that of a human, and its body is that of a lion. That is, there is a mingling, there is a mixture of a human and a lion with human head and lion's body. I have already told you that they were in front of pyramids, and according to Ishan's mother, the Sphinx is there as the symbol, as the represents of intelligence and strength. It guards the pyramids. It protects as the protector to the pyramid. I have already told you that it has human head, that is, it is the indication or embodiment of intelligence, and lion's body, that means it has the strength, or it is the embodiment of strength, power. That is why such a peculiar physical structure is given to a Sphinx. It's going to be quite a long walk in the sun. Wait here, I will go and fetch a couple of sandwiches and water from the car. Their refreshment was in the car. And his mother thinks that it will be a long journey in the sun, in the sunshine. That's why she suggests Ishan to wait there. She would go to the car in order to fetch a couple of sandwiches and water for them. Then someone is calling Ishan by his name. And you know that if someone calls you by the name, it signifies that you are known to that person. Here someone is repeating to call Ishan by his name. Ishan, Ishan. Ma, the Phoenix is talking to me. Now Ishan is in the world, or Ishan is the citizen of the dream world, or he is in a dreamlike state. That's why he cannot realize that his mother has already left him to go to the car in order to bring the refreshment for them. He is stating his mother that the Sphinx is talking to him. But the reality is that Ishan's mother was already gone. That is, Ishan's mother was not present there in order to respond to Ishan's words. From now, the conversation will take place between Ishan and the Sphinx. Then Ishan, out of his childlike innocence, asks the Sphinx, "How do you know my name?" He wanted to know how it was possible for the Sphinx to know his name. "I know many things. I know you are Ishan from Raigans. You study in class 6. Do you want to know the history of this place?" Now, the Sphinx is speaking to Ishan like a human being. Here, it states that he knows many things. He gives Ishan a lot of information. "I know you are Ishan from Raigans. I know that you are Ishan, or your name is Ishan, and you have hailed from Raigans. You have come from Raigans. You study in class 6. Not only that, I also know that you are a student of class 6. Do you want to know the history of this place?" Then the Sphinx wants to know if Ishan is interested to know the history of that place. What is that place? The place is Giza. "I don't like studying history. I can't remember dry facts." But here, the student of class 6, Ishan, expresses his disgust, his dislike for history. He can't remember the dry facts. According to him, history is nothing but the accumulation of, or the collection of, or togetherness of dry facts. "I will show you something you will never forget. Close your eyes and open them again." Then the Sphinx suggests or proposes Ishan to show him something interesting, something memorable. He instructs Ishan to close his eyes and then open it again. And Ishan is doing as per the instruction. "Ishan, Egypt is the gift of the river Nile. You know, you are now standing by the Nile. Now close your eyes and open them again. This is a journey of the imagination. Ishan, Egypt is the gift of river Nile. You know that Egypt is called the gift of the river Nile because its soil was made fertile by the river water of the Nile, and the civilization was made based on the contribution of the river Nile. You are now standing by the Nile, that is, you are very close now to the river Nile. Now close your eyes, shut your eyes and open them again. The same instruction is given by the Sphinx. Around 5000 years ago, a great civilization flourished in Egypt, mainly led by the pharaohs. The kings were wise. Here we get the same history which we have learned in the introductory paragraph. The Egyptian civilization developed nearly 5000 years ago, and it was famed by the Egyptian kings called pharaohs, known as pharaohs. Here once again the Sphinx is praising the Egyptian kings or pharaohs, and it is said that they were the wise kings or having wisdom. And the soldiers are brave, and in order to, according to the to Sphinx, the ancient civilization, Egyptian civilization, was possible because the soldiers were brave, courageous, courageous. Ancient Egypt was also a land of prosperity and festivals. Here we get a lot of information regarding ancient Egypt. Ancient Egypt was also a land, also a country of prosperity, development, flourishment and festivals, occasions. At once, Ishan expresses his curiosity to know something about pyramids. Oh, Sphinx, tell me about the pyramids. Pyramids are funerary edifices of the pharaohs. Khufu's pyramid is the biggest pyramid. Here we get another information that pyramids are the burial place of the pharaohs. And according to the Sphinx, the Khufu's pyramid is the biggest pyramid. So you may be asked, what is the biggest pyramid in Egypt? Note here, we are learning English, but at the same time we are also learning history, and I think it will be also helpful in your history class. What is mummy and how it is made? Before the burial, the bodies of royal persons had to go through mummification before the last rite of the royal bodies. It was made in the process of mummification. It was the Egyptian priests who were solely responsible for the process of mummification. The Egyptian priests found a way to preserve the dead bodies. Spices, chemicals and oils were used by them. That is how they met. Here we have a picture to show how mummy is met. It was the Egyptian priests who discovered a way to preserve the dead bodies. That is, they kept the dead bodies in such a way, or they processed the dead bodies in such a way that they would not be rotten. Spices, chemicals and oils were used as the necessary elements in order to make a mummy. That is how they made a mummy. Look, that's Queen Nefertiti, perhaps the most beautiful queen of Egypt. It was also informed by Sphinx that the Queen Nefertiti was possibly the most beautiful queen of Egypt. His king Tutankhamun, who died in his tombs. His body is preserved as a mummy. Here we get another new word, tombs. Someone who is aged between 13 and 19 is called teens or teenagers. That is, Tutankhamun was a king who died in his teen age. His body was then preserved as a mummy. That's Howard Carter, who discovered Tutankhamun's tomb in 1922. Howard Carter was a famous visitor, and he discovered the tomb or the pyramid of Tutankhamun in 1922. In the meantime, Ishan's mother has returned. I see you have not moved from the spot since I left you. His mother was astonished to see that her child Ishan has not left from that place, or he was static there. So far it was not clear to her that her child was then the citizen of a dreamland, or he was having a romantic conversation with the Sphinx in order to get information regarding pyramids and pharaohs. We are going to see a lot of amazing things yet. The pyramid of Pharaoh Khufu and the tomb of Tutankhamun. Here, his mother is giving him the information regarding the pyramid of Pharaoh Khufu and tomb of Tutankhamun. And it is now clear to you that Ishan has already a lot of information regarding the tomb of Tutankhamun. Now it is the time for Ishan to inform his mother. Ma, Khufu's pyramid is the largest in Egypt, and Tutankhamun was a teen emperor. The information which Ishan has already received from the Sphinx is being retold by Ishan here, and he is retelling it to his mother. I am immensely surprised that perhaps pharaohs and Egyptian history is so well known to you. Ishan, are you beginning to like history? His mother, or Ishan's mother, was stirred to see that Ishan has gained so much interest in history. Then she wants to know if Ishan has already started to get interested in history. Needless to say that Ishan's response is positive here. He is telling his mother that he has already begun to grow interest regarding history in his mind. Thank you, Sphinx, and the entire thanks should go to Sphinx, because he is successful enough to grow or to create interest in Ishan's mind about history. Now, with this, we are concluding our text here. You have a word nest at page 53. It will be helpful for you. And here, your duty is to go through the tell in picture many times. And then your duty is to complete the activity at the end of this lesson. And if you have any problem, you may consult me in the next class. And if you have to check anything, I shall do it when the school reopens. Now I invite those who were curious enough to ask me questions or to remove their doubt from the previous day's assignment. I invite those students now.